Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day. Ira Epstein with your agriculture update for this Tuesday, the 27th of March, 2018, just after 1:35 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Well, as you can see, the stock market is struggling. It tried the up. I had written in my overnight review that you get a strong Tuesday one way or the other. Often you get reversals of that. The dollar was down yesterday, back up today. You had a strong day in the metals. They're down. Copper was down yesterday, back up today. It's the old adage there. Now, in the grain markets, it's a little different right now. And the reason for that is the markets are getting ready for the all-important Thursday first planning report and then the stocks on hand report. So as we look at everything around the world and what the U.S. farmers are going to do, especially now that we have Good Friday and we won't be open, you get that evening up in the markets and you've got to pay attention to those type of events. At least I do. Bonds and notes getting a little bit of a bid as we're finishing up the funding right now. And as we get towards April 15th, things will start changing as the Treasury starts getting money back into its coffers. In looking at the soybeans on the weekly chart, you've now continued the break from 1060 and three quarters. Now you're down to 1019 and a half. So in round figures, we've had a 40 some odd cent break in the market. Okay, normal. And I'll call the thrust down, maybe support back at the 996 level that you take a look at. When you go to a daily area chart, and this is of closes, you can see how the market's gone from 1077 now all the way down, no longer to the 1022 and a half area that I've kept there for you to see. Now it's 1019 and a half, so I can remove that because you have a lower low, but I wanted to bring that into perspective. When we take a look at the current action in the chart, you had a stepping ladder down, you had a pop in the market, now you're coming down again. You get to see that really easy if you put swing lines on the chart. The swing line had made, and you can see it right through here, the lowest low. You then had your reversal yesterday, and today you're following through on the down. But you made the higher high yesterday intraday. That broke the pattern of lower highs, lower lows. So I'm going to call the pattern neutral. So I mean, we have to look for other things now. We didn't quite make it up to the 18-day average, so we never got to a resistance area. The support level had been hit 3 days ago at 10 and a half. And now that you've had a rally like this, if you break again, it might prove to be support one more time. And the Bollinger Band is now under that number. If you'll recall, 3 days ago, you went to both numbers. Now to get to both, you've got to extend down to 1006 and a half roughly, which would be about from here a 13 cent break in the market. And when I go to momentum, you are just plain oversold. Now, admittedly, both numbers that make up the slow stochastic are under 20. The traditionalists look that any reading under 20 is oversold. I'm not a traditionalist. I look at the market that, yes, it's oversold, and I go to the day before also. Both numbers were not under 20. Therefore, it's just oversold. Get several days in a row under a 20 reading consecutive. I say the market converts from being oversold into locking in a bear trend. You haven't done that. You're just oversold, market coming down. We'll see how the markets react tomorrow. In the meal market, the battleground for 3 days has been at the red line, the 18-day average of closes. I call that the line in the sand. And the reason I call it the line in the sand is often the 18-day average is a number that I'll call, and I think a lot of traders look at certain numbers on charts of moving averages as a neutral number. When the market is above it, I give it a bullish bias. Under it, a bearish bias. I always use it as a filter on swing lines. So what I have right now are the swing lines in the meal saying, hey, higher lows, higher highs, bullish. But the close has been under the 18-day average, downside bias. The two cancel each other out. In the interim, you've been getting a bounce in the market, and what the market is now doing is it's worked off an oversold condition. Now, fundamentally speaking, what nobody really knows yet is how the crops are in Argentina. We know they were damaged, don't get me wrong. But how much damage is what we're looking to see if the government even addresses in this report. And that'll be a key number, especially for the meal market, because any way you look at it, Argentina is a major, major producer of beans and meal especially. Soybean oil still has one of these crazy patterns, a lower low, actually you have lower highs, then you've got a low that got a bounce and now you're dropping again. There's no trend. The market is respecting the lower Bollinger Band each time it gets near it. It's oversold as well. In the corn market, we have a pattern just yesterday where you made that higher high again. You had follow through from Friday, made a higher high, couldn't hold it, had follow through to the downside. Now, when I look right here at the momentum is oversold. So we have a market that has come in from the 395 level all the way back 20 cents. It sounds like a lot, but it's not a tremendous amount. And it's probably going to be a market that makes us wait and see the reaction to the first planting reports. In the wheat market, we have a market that is still questioning how the drought in the Southwest is going to look. That's going to be a big issue for this report. In terms of momentum, it's embedded. What does that mean? It's locked into the bear side. So until the red line closes back over 20, I view each rally that this market has as an opportunity where the bears keep hitting this market. I'd say they'd bail if you get over that 20 level on a closing basis. In the sugar market, you have a market that is oversold. The pattern is still, I forgot to make a change yesterday. This should be pointing down. You got lower highs, lower lows, oversold condition, probably a market that's getting ahead of itself. In the coffee market, you had a rally that stalled right at the 18-day average. We get that so often. Momentum-wise, the market is still in a bit of an oversold condition. When it was up today, back towards that 119.70 level, it was not in an oversold condition. But when it settled back on the close, it gathered it again. We'll see what it can do tomorrow. In the cocoa market, one more time, we've lost the embedded reading. What does that mean? When you have a reading, and was it embedded? Let's first check that, then I can show you something. Both numbers are over 80. The day before, both numbers over 80, and the day before. When you get three consecutive in a row, it changes the momentum from being overbought to locking in a bull trend. When it loses that reading, often, not the word always, price in the 18-day average of closes try to make a run at each other. So we'll see if that's going to be the case tomorrow. Right now, you've got a lower low, a higher high pattern, lost upside momentum, 18-day average potential support. In the cotton market made a rally today in an oversold condition. It's got lower highs. It had lower lows, but if you take a look now at the low that we made here at 81.39, right there, if we come to this day's low, it's 80.95. So I could argue that we're in a stall. That could change by taking out this 81.39 level, which then gives the market a target of 80.77. The dilemma for the market is it's oversold going into a planting report. I don't know that it deserves any attention one way or the other. It seems to me you're rolling the dice, just throw them in the air. Which way are the acres going to fall? The talk is that the cotton acres will be up. We saw today that China is imported about 26% less cotton than they did normally for the month of February. We'll see what that all means. In the cattle, you still have the impact of that terribly bearish cattle on feed, two of them back-to-back, actually, that just keep breaking the markets down as we've got an awful lot of animals. We know we have relatively low-cost feed. The way you get rid of low-cost feed, you feed it to your animals, and that seems to be what we're doing. You even see that in the feeders, obviously, as this market has stayed into a depressed mode. Both these markets have embedded readings. You see that? So until they lose them, rallies in the market, I feel, will still be sold by the pros. And in the hog market, well, you know, everybody talks about, you know, how bad American pork will be hurt with China if there's a tariff. Folks, Smithfield, the WH Group owns them out of China. They only export 7% of their pork back to China, by the way. So, yes, it's an impact, but I don't know that pork's really as big a market as people talk. And the reason is the one market the Chinese are really going wild in are their hog farms. And they're commercial in size, they're large, and that is something that they've been breeding. So we'll see what that all means. You put it all together, you try to put two and two together to see what these markets will do, and it's been a lot of volatility. I personally think the volatility is going to stay in the market. And because of that, I'm writing about it regularly. Now, you're going to want to know about, if you're in agriculture and you're watching this, what does it all mean for the crop reports, the stocks? I'm going to be writing on that Thursday. I'll give you a complete review on it. I did a lot of cotton research today for people. How do you get my research? It's really simple. Give us a call, 866-973-2077. You can go to our website, www.iraepstein.com. You'll see our free offers. Click on any, it'll be there. You can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube, or underneath us on many websites, it says click here for Ira's free info. I'm Ira Epstein. You all have a great day, and I will see you tomorrow.